Mr. Basavaraddi. Basavaraddi is a very dear friend of ours, and he is a dear friend of our father, as my father as well. He has come many times to our house and shared fond memories with my father. Mr. Basavaraddi is the director of Moraji Desai National Institute of Yoga. And if today we have what is called International Yoga Day, part of the credit goes to him. The other part also to Mr. Modi, but part of the credit goes to him, because Mr. Basavaraddi has been pushing for recognition of yoga as throughout India and throughout the world. He is a champion of yoga, especially from our motherland, from its motherland. So I'm very, very fortunate that he immediately accepted. He said, "I will come and I will stay for both days." So I'm very, very happy that he's done. He is very fond of my father. They are also from the same state, Mysore, Karnataka. And he is a scholar, very good scholar. So you will see his class when he starts speaking. So, sir, please, we welcome you. And please, sir, this is the hot spot for all the speakers. And I'm going to request one of our colleagues to welcome him in an appropriate manner. Where is our elder? So I can't find our elder. Where is our elder? Oh, Mr. GRV, please, sir. Mr. GRV is one of our teachers and very old student of my father. So we're going to ask him to offer the shawl and fruits to Mr. Basavaraddi.
My pranams to all the elders and the great yogacharyas, and also my brothers and sisters, my pranams to you all. At the outset, I thank Dr. Kausthub and Amma and all the disciples of Dr. Desikachar. Now onwards I will call him as sir, for giving me an opportunity to come and sit with you people. And I feel it's my privilege and honor. This is the land of yogis. And we remember and saw only few yogis in the history. There are lakhs and lakhs of yogis. Till today, they are unknown to many. So, I am not a yoga person, but for the childhood, I started searching for these unknown yogis. And today, when I wake up, I have a blank mind because I don't know much about anything. But when I wake up and sit down for a minute, the first sentence comes in my mother language: knowing the unknown. That's the journey. So today is the day to know the people who are remain to be unknown. In my opinion, people are starving hard to make the name and fame. But real yogis, they live their life and they never wanted to be recognized or named. But people recognize them. But people follow them. People enlighten themselves by the way they live, by knowing, by understanding. And Sir was one of such legend who wanted to be, according to me, the unknown, but he is very known today. And before I proceed, my pranams and my tributes to that great soul from the inner core of my heart. And for a few years, I was in the ministry proposing some names to Padma Awards. I am not the student of these great star awards, but I had a connection. I don't know what is my Purva Karmas. I met Guruji Iyengarji, Ammaji, Jaydevji in Bombay, and even Sir Swami Veda. First time, but I found everybody recognized me, not as a director when I was the teacher in the university. Recognized me and speaking like we know for several years. So that makes me wonder how these people connect within without any taking time and feeling, making me to feel that I am the part of them. We know from several years and years and years. That's the wonderful feeling I had. With that, I tried to unite these people. And we formed the Indian Yoga Association in 2008. That's all, nothing else. But I was recommending some of the great yogis of the present time, contemporary times, for the Padma Awards. Year after year, just I proposing but not putting any pressure. Let government or anybody think that these people shall be recognized. They don't want, but they should be recognized. Even I not informed to the KYM or people. Same thing about Jaydev's, many others. But in 2014, when Prime Minister Modiji has started, International Day of Yoga has came late. But after he is taking the charge, and one after the other, instructions have come from the PMO, Prime Minister Office too. We want to do in yoga this, that, that. So one of the move was to, there are two important moves. One is to propose for the International Day of Yoga. And the second one is intangible cultural heritage of humanity, yoga as intangible cultural heritage. And I was this senior most officer. Many responsibilities has come through. So when even they are proposing there in the, when Prime Minister made in September 27th. So after that there was debate, we had to propose the date to celebrate International Day of Yoga. It's a very interesting story. So there are so many teachers, somebody want Vivekananda's birthday as a International Day of Yoga. And all the Guruji's, Iyengar students want December 14th. And like this many. And ultimately in 2004 itself, some of the yoga people have started this celebrating International Day of Yoga on June 21st, giving it is the longest and auspicious day. So I proposed 2-3 dates, and ultimately we consolidated on June 21st. So one of my joint secretary was very skeptic. He go on Ashtani. Yoga people are very clever people. And he directly asked me, "Is June 21st is your birthday, Mr. Basavaraddi?" So luckily, sir, it's not mine. I am June 19th. Otherwise, he was very, not only jokingly, but he's very skeptic. People are very clip your name like this. And honestly speaking, I was not aware that June 21st was the birth date of sir. Why I'm telling this story? Without knowingly, now we are celebrating International Day of Yoga. And the same day, we are celebrating the birthday of sir. Is it not the honor to the sir? I feel it. It's not only the honor, it's only the great Rishi Parampara, what they were celebrating. It's only the day, the longest day, the auspicious day. So like this, yoga has reached to the doors of many have closed, irrespective of the religion, caste, cadre, and the region, and the country. Because of this, the great sadhana they did under the mentorship of the great teachers. We call it as a Guru Shishya Parampara. So nowadays, yoga is being marketed even in the government. There's always said that you have to market yoga. When PM also proposed, like a software, we have to marketing the yoga, make it popular, marketing it. But as a student of yoga, yoga is not a commodity. So we never want that. But it is being marketed, knowingly, unknowingly, by our own disciples. Even the disciples of sir or anybody, B.K. Sengarji or Gitanand Giriji, whatever it may be. So that's why I am the strong opposer for such type of marketing yoga, because I believed and experienced the true nature of yoga under the individual mentorship of these great rishis. I call them rishis. Because yoga sadhana is not so simple what we nowadays see in the media. For me, it's not so simple. But it is not also complicated. It is as simple as our life. It is as simple as our life. But if you make our life miserable, if you might make our life complicated, and we can make our life very easy and simple. For me, yoga is simple as we live simple. And if you want to make it complicated, it becomes complicated. This is what I learned from the teachings of Sir Viniyoga of Yoga. That's the one thing I appreciate. I hardly met Sir only few times, because my route, I started my first lessons in 1975 when I was in the 7th standard. And in 1976, I read one small book I purchased giving 6 rupees, Yogasanagalu in Kannada language. And by the great master, still the pose, even the how much length you had to the Paschimottanasana, everything it has given, matra, I couldn't understand a boy. Oh, yoga is very difficult, very complicated. But I started standing in Shirshasana for a few minutes, and sometime in the degree my almost many minutes, sometime crossing more than hour. So without any guru, we used to learn like this. And that one book inspired. I have to reach that standards what has mentioned in that. So that's the connection I had. And Mysuru is one of the place we love, all the Karnataka people. And same thing Madras, now it is Chennai. And Dharwad. These are the 3 spaces where always the scholars are residing. The culture, the literature, the ancient wisdom I found in these cities. Many others are there for me, the Mysore and Madras and many Iyengars. Many legends are living in the Madras and also in the Mysore. Their entire culture is yoga culture. If you come to our Dharwad city, if you throw any one stone, it will fall on any poet or a magician. That's the saying. So that's why such a culture, how it comes, it's yoga. Many people now, it's only some asanas, some breathing practices, not even pranayama. People talk about meditation, but they never even understood meditation. They never practiced meditation. Even some yoga nidra or guided meditation, they said it's meditation. So that's why I found these yogis. I come to the point, I search in southern Maharashtra and northern Karnataka in my earlier days for these yogis. I found the yogis in illiterate people who can't even write. They are perfect yogis. I found a lady in an unknown village doing yoga sadhana without speaking, without taking even a drop of water for 10 days in the Navaratri. I still remember that day. Such type of huge experiences I searched in different parts of the country and also in the Nepal. One fine day, my father took to that village. He was the headmaster there. Then after the Navaratri, I was sitting just as some queries has come. She never speak. But she started, she is called Mauna Tapasvi. First time she started some chantings in the or regional language in the couplet formats. So one or two after that, I found that whatever it's coming in my mind, she start answering that. It become a dialogue kind of thing. So I was surprised. Then it went on for 30-40 minutes. So people are afraid she has not taken anything. She may get faint or something. So then Amma, you calm down. Then she said that boy is sitting and he is doing some. That's why I had to tell. So then they ask, are you, sir, please silent. Then I just close my eyes, I silent and that lady. So like this, yoga connects like that. It's my true experience. And even I met Jaydevji and many people. Even I went to Amma's ashram. In some place I found the vibrations. We connect. That's why I don't feel these, they are immortal. Only physical body is not there, Anytime you want to connect with that, you can connect with Sir. That's the only two things I would like to. Just we are searching for the unknowns. We want to know the unknowns. And they want to remain unknown, but they are known too. But we can connect anytime. I can speak of some of his work, etc. But I found such type of yogis. But today is the time. Sometime I become desperate as a government officer. Because still I said, I am a student, but today also I don't say courageously, I am a student. I am not practicing what people say yoga. I left it in 2003 itself. So that's why sometime even I'm afraid I'm a student of yoga. But I say I am the lover of yoga. I am the profound lover of yoga. I studied nearly 8 years of the school, different schools and lineages. And I had a lot of respect about this culture after studying and understanding. That's why I love the great tradition of Krishnamacharya. Honestly, I was not aware of the earlier one. I know only after Ramanuja and Vedanta Desika and next. But earlier one, I was not aware. Like this, there are three things I in the yoga. One is it's a prasthana tree, Shruti prasthana, then Naya prasthana, then Sadhana prasthana. So Vedanta, so this all the Vedantic teachings one side. Maybe it is Advaita, Vishishta Advaita, Dvaita, different formats. Even the great acharyas of Vedanta school. In the same way, second one is in the Mimamsa, many people don't consider. But people love the Vedanta teachings, not as the form of yoga, but Vedanta is different. But in entire Indian philosophy or darshana, we ask only 5 questions. The nature of Brahman, the God. The nature of Atman, the Self. The nature of the world. And what is the goal? What is the means? For me, the means in every darshana is yoga. Maybe it is Vedanta, it may be Sankhya, yoga, whatever it is. So that's why I find 3 distinct streams in the main, and the 4th one, we go to the Buddhism, Jainism also, but in the entire Vedanta, Vedic tradition, the Prasthana Tree and Vedanta. The 2nd one is purely on the mind, completely rational. I did my master's in physics basically. That's why many times I found we are matching as a student of science, Desikachar, and we think in a similar line. Even the concept of God or the Ishvara, if you are a Vishishta Advaiti, and you never agree for that. Even Iyengarji has always said, Ishvara is the, but for us he is a Vishesha Purusha, just a symbol, how, what we can do, become once we achieve that. Only thing is he is a Vishesha, and we are just Purusha, because we have come across the Klesha Karma Vipakasha. I'll complete. So that's why the Sankhya Veda, yoga tradition has become more popular, because its systematic approach, very systematic approach, and thousands people from the ancient time, from the Veda Vyasa, has given the first Vyasa commentary, Bhashya, Vyasa Bhashya. From that till today, it's a fashion for everybody to write. So that's why even in this tradition, I come to the chanting of Yoga Sutra. That book, I think 75 rupees book, I still very perfect. Small, small contribution, but they are great contributions. Because if you chant, you may not be the student of Sanskrit. But go on chanting in a proper manner, once, twice, thrice, 10 times, 20 times, you start understanding the content of the entire nature. Every time that sutra gives you dwelling, so you can start understanding yourselves and the entire nature. That's the wonderful thing I found in the Yoga Sutra of Patanjali by proper understanding and chanting. And the third one is coming from the Agama Shastra, Tantra and Hatha Yoga and all these things. Here in this parampara, the culmination of these three mainstream of thoughts and sadhana, the Vedanta, the Sankhya Yoga, and the Hatha Yoga and Agama Shastra, whatever it may be. So that's the wonderful thing. That's why this has been accepted worldwide. Krishnamacharya ji or his teachers may be the first, but now the Desikachar ji, Iyengar ji, Indra Devi ji, Pattabhi ji, and all these legends, now their third generation is continuing their teaching. And like this, we have a Shivananda, Swami Shivananji, Gitananji, Swami Dhirendra Brahmacharya ji. So it's endless. That's why I always remember Sir Radhakrishnan's word, this entire, the Bharata Bhumi. So it's everything God has given, everything here. The nature is so friendly. We don't need any scarcity to live healthy and happy. Mother Earth has given everything. That's why the breathe we breathe, it's a spiritual. We have to see the eternal things just by the sitting here in this land. So it's let us see these dreams and great teachings, feel it, and let us become the instrumental to transfer into the next generation. This is the great things or tribute to we do these great sales. The entire life they live very simple in the service of the mankind by their continuous sadhana. And now it is for us. Not by speaking or something. We have to take it to the next generation and generation, so that this parampara will continue. Before conclude, yoga has seen many ups and downs. Many people have come. Sometime yoga might have disappeared. Again it emerged. That's the one thing I always love. We face many hurdles in the implementation of the classical yoga. Many people are in the government, they don't appreciate. They want the quick things to happen. So in such case, we become desperate. But the entire history of yoga motivate me. So even after 5,000 years, yoga remains because it has the strength. Any system survive for many decades and thousands of years. It cannot be unless it has the 100%. For me, yoga is a journey from the finite to the infinite. So how much we lead towards the infinite, that much happiness we had. We may lose and gain in some worldly life, but for me, yoga is a journey from the finite to infinite. Let the path shown. Now, Kausthub, he is carrying out. We have association with Krishnamacharya Yoga Mandiram. And also now the one more. Both organization has been founded by Sir. And would like to continue this tradition in my institution. Last few months back, my secretary was here. We used to made them to visit because they are the policy makers to Pandi's Amma's Ashram and here in KYM and here. He was quite impressed by the way you give therapy. He has given in writing to start your yoga therapy course in MDNY. The way the Krishnamacharya tradition gives the one-to-one therapy classes, KYM is giving. That's the influence you made in a very short time on this auspicious occasion. Within few months, we are going to have such type of courses or facilities in our institution. Because in a national, Delhi is a wonderful place. It's a city of opportunities. Sometime you do 100 things here, you don't come. But there even you do one thing, it will globally recognized. Hope so in the days to come. The teachings of Krishnamacharyaji and his disciples will bring the front of the entire classical yoga so that larger community has been benefited. But I saw him, not his father but his grandfather. I saw his books, so fascinating. I left my science and started philosophical studies because I don't find that research is going on today or helpful for the promotion. Whatever the scientists are doing, they are not practicing yoga. That's why I left the very fascinating and recognizable field of scientific research, clinical research. I devoted to the literary research. I love the Kausthub because he chosen that path to go for searching and publishing the ancient textbooks. Now it is job. What his father has left, grandfather, T. Krishnamacharyaji, might have thought, but he has might have not done. Now it is his to carry. And what his father did, but he has not done several things. Now you have to carry. And you have to carry the and reach to the expectations of the people. And so that, and we are here to be with you, or we're all the whole family and whole paramparas are the Rishi culture supporting. Only thing, we have to forget our small differences. That's the only always I made the request. Keep it aside and smile, and we can together lead towards the goal of yoga. So with these few words, so I hope Kausthub and his entire Shishya Parampara and Shishya Parampara of Sir and etc. will take up this, what has been not done, not only their messages, something they have not able to done, because I know that during those days, teaching yoga is not simple. So I know my teacher used to go to the school, and even we used to go in the earlier days, school, colleges, and put the half pant, and we used to demonstrate. So that was the yoga. And when I left from physics to thing, my teacher has called, why are you going to that department of circus department? So that was the notion about yoga. And they scolded me, my physics professor, you are a wonderful student of physics, for leaving this field and going there. So that was the notion about yoga. Yoga means just a physical posture. Even a young Arji used to demonstrate. My teacher was the contemporary, and they used to demonstrate to influence the people. But it's not only the asana. For me, it is our culture, it is our lifestyle. That's why I'm telling, it's in our blood. Just we have to feel it and practice it. That's yoga. Even though you are not practicing some asanas or pranayama, but yoga is there with you. Yoga is to connect. Yoga is to finite, to the infinite. In that journey, we meet several people. And it's a wonderful friend, Kausthub. And always love. We speak less, and we don't come in Facebook. Many times you come, hardly we have that opportunity, we don't like. But we connect. Even if you say one time, we connect. Wherever it is there, we connect. This is the way we can proceed. So once again, on this auspicious day, I wish you all a very happy Makar Sankranti. It's my privilege to be here on the eve of Pongal. And thank you very much. Namaskar. Dhanyavad. Thank you. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.